Hello and welcome to the 39th video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how you can easily duplicate and edit an animation sequence in After Effects. In the previous episode, we created the video sequence that will play in the background of the first section of the video presentation. In this video, we are going to focus on the animation sequence right at the start of the section. We are going to look at how we can create this pin animation sequence. So in this video, we will be covering the following topics: duplicating comps, editing comps, and parenting layers. So let's get into it. So here I am, where we left off in the previous episode where we created this video sequence for the Hyde Park section. Now, if you are watching for the first time and wish to follow along, you can find this document in the project folder, which you can download. The link is in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. With the project folder open, click into folder 3, create a project, then into folder 39, duplicate and edit an animation sequence, and open the duplicate and edit an animation sequence document. Now, looking at my sketch timeline I planned earlier on in the project, I want to introduce a pin animation at the front of each section with a number on it. Now back in After Effects, if I come back to the main comp and drag my time indicator over the first part of the presentation, we can recall that earlier in the process we animated these pins. So this animation already exists. So what we're going to do is use the same animation but make a few changes. So I'll come back to the Hyde Park comp by clicking on the tab, and I'll come over to the project panel. Now if I look inside the pre-comps folder, we should see the animation comp we created earlier called pin. This is the animation we used for the first section. So let's go ahead and use this. Now before I drag in the pin animation, I'm first going to duplicate it. Now I need to duplicate the comp because I am about to make some changes and I don't want to affect the pins being used on the first intro sequence. So with the pin comp selected, in the project panel I'll press Command D on Mac or Control D on PC to duplicate the comp layer. Upon click, we'll get a new comp and the name will change to pin 2. Now, in this instance, we don't want this to be called pin 2. This needs to be called pin 1. So I'll press enter on the new comp layer, which will allow us to change the name, and I'll rename this comp to pin 1. So now I'm ready to place it into my Hyde Park comp. So I'll press Command/ on Mac or Control/ on PC to place the comp into my Hyde Park comp. So I'll click on the colored box for the new comp layer and change this to blue. And now I can come into the comp and make some changes. So I'll double click on the new comp layer to open it up. And here we can see a copy of the pin we animated earlier. So what we're going to do is change the color of the pin, remove the circle part of the graphic in the middle and replace it with a number. So let's start by changing the color of the pin. So I'll select the layer and come up and click on the color box at the top of the interface next to the word fill. So down below, I'll type in the following hex code and I'll type 274E9D and click OK. So now I need to get rid of the circle part in the middle. So I'll come down into the timeline panel and toggle down the layer to reveal the content. I'll toggle the contents down to reveal the two shapes that make up this pin. Here we have group 1 and 2. So right now, group 1 is the circle in the middle and group 2 is the outer bit. So I'll select group 1 and just press delete, and that will remove the centerpiece. Nice. So I'll just press U on the layer to remove all the other info and just reveal the keyframes. Now I'm going to place a number inside the circle. So I'll press Command T on Mac or Control T on PC to activate the type tool. And I'll click near the center of the circle like so and type the number 1. In the character panel, I'll change the type to around 190 so it fits nicely into the circle. And I'll click on the color box and make sure it's set to a white color. Then I'll click on the selection tool in the tools menu, click the new type layer and move it into the center of the circle like so. Nice. But now we have a little problem. If I scrub my time indicator over the first keyframes for the pin, we can see the animation is happening, but the type layer is not moving anywhere. What we need to do now is animate this number 1 so it moves in time with the pin animation. Now, to do this would be fiddly and a little time consuming, but here we can use a really simple technique that is going to solve this problem right away. What I can do here is parent the type layer to the pin below. So with the number in place, I'll come down into the timeline panel and look over to the left of the panel. What I need to see here is the parent and link option for the type layer. Now, if you cannot see this, simply click on the column title area, scroll down to columns and make sure parent and link is ticked. So with the parent and link option available, first select the type layer, then move the time indicator along the timeline so it's placed after the animation sequence, then carefully come and click the pick whip icon, drag it out like so and place it on top of the pin layer below. Upon release, we should now see the parent and link option for the type layer set to 2 pin. Now, if we scrub the time indicator over the first frame for the pin, we will now see that the type layer moves and bounces with the pin. By parenting the type layer to the pin layer, it will assume its movements. Perfect. But in this instance, it does not take the opacity sequence. So what we will need to do is animate the opacity to make it transition the same as the pin. To do this is easy. So what I'll do here is come and select the opacity keyframes from the pin layer below. With them both selected, I'll copy them, then drag the time indicator right to the start of the comp. I'll select the type layer and paste. Now if I press U to show the keyframes, we can see the same keyframes from the pin below, which we just pasted onto the new type layer. So as I move my time indicator over the keyframes, we now have the opacity matching. Great. So to finish this off, I'm going to add motion blur. Notice we have the motion blur icon checked on the pin layer below, which we set earlier. I'll now just come and check this on the type layer. So I'll press spacebar to activate preview, and we can see that is looking just fine. So I'll press spacebar to stop, and I'll click back onto the Hyde Park tab to come back to the main comp. So now we can see we have our new pin at the start, but right now it's looking a little small, and it's not positioned correctly in the frame. So I'll press S on the keyboard to activate scale. I'll come down and drag the scale settings to scale up the pin, and when happy, I'll position in the middle of the frame. Now, what I want to do next is transition the pin out once it bounces in. So what I'll need to do here is move my time indicator to where I want my pin to transition out. And I want it to transition out just before the video edits to the next video. So with my time indicator in the right place, I'll double click back onto my pin comp layer. Now, what will happen is the comp will open up and my time indicator is placed exactly where I want it in relation to the previous comp. So now I'll come down and click on the diamond icon to add a new position keyframe on the pin layer. Now I'll drag my time indicator back a little and I'll click the diamond icon again to add another position keyframe. With my two keyframes, I'll drag my time indicator back to the last keyframe while holding shift to snap. And with the time indicator over the last frame, I'll press and hold the down arrow on the keyboard while holding shift to quickly move the pin out of shot. Next, I'll come and click on this new third keyframe for position. I'll right click, scroll down to keyframe assistance and come across and select easy ease out. Next, I'll click on the last keyframe for position. I'll right click, scroll down to keyframe assistant, come across and select easy ease in. So now if I come back to my Hyde Park comp and drag my time indicator, we can now see the pin animating away. Now if this looks a little too fast and not quite right, we can double click back into the pin comp and just click and adjust the last two keyframes like so. Then back into the Hyde Park comp and see how that looks. What we want to achieve here is the pin transitioning out just as the video is sliding in like so. So now what we currently have is this big long layer. Next, I'm going to clean this up. So I'll double click back into the pin comp, and we don't really need the layer to be any longer after the pin has animated away. So I'll put my time indicator over the last keyframe and just under the composition panel. It will state at which time we are set on the timeline. So I'll click on this to pull up the time menu. I'll come into the time, select it and copy and hit OK. Next, I'll press Command K on Mac or Control K on PC to pull up the composition settings. When the box appears, I'll come down into duration. Right now we can see this is set to 5 seconds. So I'll come into this, select it all and paste. This will paste in the new timestamp we just copied and I'll click OK. and the comp will now be set to the new time, which is approximately the time of my pin animation. So now I'll click the X on the tab to close it and come back to the Hyde Park comp tab. And now we can see the layer is trimmed, so we can see exactly how much time that sequence takes. So I'll place my time indicator at 1.5 seconds and press N to set the end of the workspace area, and I'll press spacebar to activate preview. So that's how we can easily duplicate an animation sequence in After Effects and make changes to repurpose for other parts of a video presentation. Now, it really pays to be savvy when creating your animated sequences, as you can save a lot of time and work recycling your animations. So that's the first animation part complete for the Hyde Park section. Now, if you're following along, I would recommend you save your document so we can continue on in the next episode. Now, we can move on and create the rest of the animation sequence. So, looking back at the Photoshop design, we can see a number of layers here. We have a title, subtitle, these decorative elements here in the middle, and some type below. So what we're going to do next is build up the layout on top of the video edit we just created. In the next video, we are going to build this layout and add animation. So see you in the next video.